Welcome students. We are studying French Revolution, CBSC class 9, first chapter of history. The two lectures of this chapter have already been completed and uploaded that you can access by clicking on the I button on the top right corner of your screen. So in the previous videos, the first video we saw about the storming of Bastille, its significance, how Louis XVI became the king of France, and what challenges he faced. In the next video, we have studied about the structure of the French society during the old regime, that is first estate, second estate, and third estate. And we also seen various taxes paid by third estates and what were those taxes and what percent they were paid. We had also seen what is subsistence crisis. And we had also seen that when Louis XVI became the king of France, the French treasury was empty. Then the king had no other option than imposing a new tax. So in this video, we'll be studying about how the revolution started and the beginning point, the triggering point or the sparking point where the revolution started. In this lecture, we will be studying about the concept of estate general. What was estate general and how it functioned, and what was the role that estate general had in making new laws or levying or imposing new taxes. We'll also see the system of voting in the estate general. Estate general was a kind of parliament, and what system was there, and old and the new system we'll see there of voting. Then the result of the meeting of the estate general was the tennis court oath. What was the tennis court oath? What was the outcome of it? Then formation of the National Assembly in France and the major decisions taken by the National Assembly, and how King was forced to accept the constitution which the National Assembly had made. Okay, to begin with, we have seen that when Louis XVI became the King of France, he had found the empty treasury. And we had also seen the reasons why the French treasury was empty. Whatever may be the reason, we have already studied them, but a king could not survive without filling the treasury. Bina khazane ke koi king kabhi bhi rule nahi kar sakta. And the best way to raise money for the regular expenses of the state is to impose a new tax. And the king had no other option than imposing new tax, because imposing or levying new tax is the fastest and the easiest way to raise fund for the government. So the king had to impose a new tax, but there was a procedure which had to be followed in order to impose a new tax. And what was the procedure? The king had to take the permission or approval of the estate general. Now you should know what is estate general. First remember this: a king could impose a new tax after the approval of the estate general. Now estate general was a parliament, a kind of parliament or assembly, we can say that. We'll see about this in the next slides. Here, the king, earlier king, the kings before the Louis XVI undermined the importance of estate general. They give almost negligible or no importance at all to the estate general, and the previous kings imposed, levied. Levy means naya tax lagane ko, levy is a correct word. Jaise ki song can be sung, song can't be told, story can be told, story cannot be sung. In the same way, tax, the best way is levy. Impose bhi ab bol sakte, but the best word is levy. So earlier kings levied new taxes even without the approval of the estate general. They undermined the estate general because the kings were absolute. But it was the king's decision whether to call the meeting of the estate general or not. It means what we come to know here about the estate general, it was a kind of consultative body for the king. If king needed the advice of the estate general, then king would call the estate general. If the king doesn't need the advice or consultation of the estate general, king would not call, rather king would take his own decision. It was like that. So it was not compulsory for Louis XVI to call the meeting of the estate general and ask for the approval to impose a new tax. Earlier kings did not do this procedure. They levied new taxes by their own. So see the example how the earlier king did not give importance to its estate general. That last meeting was called in 1614. And which year we are talking about? We are talking about 1789. And last meeting was called 1614. Now you can understand what a gap. How many kings were there ruled in between which did not call a meeting of Estates General even once? But Louis XVI is bande ko khujri aayi thi, and this man called the meeting of the Estates General. Then what happened? Then he called the meeting of the Estates General. First of all, Estates General was an assembly of the three states. We have studied in the previous videos, France during the old regime, the society was organized in three states. State 1, clergy, people related to church and the church related activities. Second state was nobility, people related to administration, like Kshatriya we say in India, and clergy means Brahmins. And third, the commoners, all the people other than the clergy and the nobility would fall under this category. So all the representatives of each state, remember that, a representative of each state were sent to the meeting of the Estates General. It means somewhere every state had its own elections, every state elected or selected whatever procedure was there, their representatives, and those elected or selected representatives were sent to the state general, meeting of the state general. Okay, it means some figure are given here. How many people used to come from clergy all over the France? 300 clergy would attend the meeting of a state general as a representatives of the clergy class. The nobility also used to send 300 representatives from all over the France. 300 representatives would come to the meeting of a state general, and commoners had their 600 representatives. Of course, their population was approximately 90% of the population they were, so they deserve more representatives. The more number of representatives from the third state would come. Okay, understood this? How many people were present in the meeting of the Estates General? There were 1200 people were presented at the meeting of the Estates General. Out of those 1200, as you now know, 300 from clergy and 300 from nobility and 600 from commoners. So 1200. But when the voting practiced, there were not 1200 votes in the meeting of the Estates General, but there were only 3 votes in the meeting of the Estates General. So how are 3 votes? Now king, whenever king used to raise any question, maybe the king says, king is saying that I want to take this decision, so I want your help, I need your advice. So all these 300 people would go to their separate place. This all 300 people will discuss their own, and they will come on a common point that we will either support or oppose this decision. So one vote is decided. All these 300, out of 300, 160 people said that we will say yes. So 160 is the majority figure among the 300. Similar process occurred here also. All the 300 people discussed their own, and maybe 170 said that we will support the topic raised by king. And there 600, out of 600, 315 said that we would oppose to the king's decision. So what would happen? One vote in favor of king, one vote in favor of king, that is 2 votes, and one vote against the king. So entire meeting state general had only 3 votes. Okay, is this system is clear? That again very important. So what is written there? Each state had 1 vote. So throughout the meeting of state general there were 3 votes. And of course from the third state, who came? Only educated and rich members of the society, commoners would come there. Poor peasants and women were not allowed. But important, this is very important, these people, representatives of the third state, brought 40,000 letters. Now imagine you have a book which has 40,000 pages. How thick book would be? Or suppose you have a book which had only 1,000 pages. Imagine your normal books are 200 to 300 pages. So how many books? It means maybe your entire shelf is filled with the letters. So this is clear the basics about the Estates General. Let's move on now. Now this is the day, 5th May 1789. This is that day on which the meeting of the Estates General was called. Remember this, this is important. When meeting was called? 5th May 1789. King called the meeting of Estates General on 5th of May. Why? Because he wanted to impose a new tax. Why he wanted to impose the new tax, we have already seen, because the French treasury was empty. And obviously the second video we have seen, If there is any tax, only third estate would have to pay the tax, because the clergy and the nobility, these two estates were exempted from paying all the taxes. And if there is any tax, that would be paid by third estate. So if the new tax is approved now, that would be paid by the third estate. So what is the principle of voting in the estate general? Old system was each estate had one vote. Remember, old system, each estate had one vote. But now, new principles, like Rousseau and other philosophers we have studied earlier, because of the influence of those people, representatives of the third estate were demanding, no, one is a state, one vote is a wrong principle. We want one person, one vote. Now remember, there were only three votes. Now these people are demanding there should be 1200 votes in the meeting of the estate general. Do you think King would approve it now? I don't think so, because King wanted to impose a new tax which won't be paid by the first and the second estate. So these two estates would support the King's proposal of imposing new tax, and King knew that third estate would definitely oppose. But the proposal of the King would be passed, because two would be the votes in favor of King. So that he was sure. So he expecting one person, one estate, one vote. But the people insisted on one person, each person, one vote. And King refused this. And of course King would refuse, otherwise King's plan would be failed. King won't be able to impose a new tax if all the 100% these 600 people would vote against the proposal, and even a one person from these clergy and nobility which supports them, King's proposal would be failed. Okay, so King refused it, but third estate was insistent, no, we want one person, one vote. We won't participate in the voting if there is one estate, one vote. King was still adamant, no, I won't accept this, we will follow one state, one vote. And people were also strong on the demand, there should be one person, one vote. And there was a deadlock, and out of this deadlock, the third state walked out of the meeting of a state general. Rona state general ki meeting chodke chale gaye. So this is the procedure. The King would be sitting somewhere here, the people of first state and third state were sitting, and the representatives of third state, sorry, first and second estate were sitting, and third estate was standing behind. This was the structure of the hall. So what happened next? When the representatives of third estate walked out, उन्होंने hall वो जो hall छोड़ दी, जिस hall में the hall in which the meeting was being held, and they walked out of that hall and straight away went to tennis court. There was a tennis court now. Louis XVI was the king, and he had the habits like the kings. So this 600 people walked out of the meeting of a state general and went to the tennis court. And there inside the tennis court, all those 600 representatives were declared themselves as a national assembly. Remember that. They declared themselves as the national assembly. The 600 representatives of the third estate walked out indoor tennis court, to the indoor tennis court, and there they declared themselves the National Assembly. They thought that these 600 representatives were the representative of the entire French population. Of course, 90%, were they right? Of course, they represented the 90% population. So we are the two representatives, and those 600 people are representatives of only those, means nobility and clergy. They were the representatives of only 10% population, and we, the commoners, were the representatives of 90%. So we are the National Assembly. So they, in the national, in the court, in the indoor tennis court, these people took an oath. Which oath these people had taken? They took the oath that we will not disperse from this tennis court until and unless we draft a constitution for France. And which kind of constitution we would draft? We would draft such a constitution which would limit the powers of the King. मतलब इन लोगों ने शपथ ले ली इंडोर टेनिस कोर्ट में, हम इस टेनिस कोर्ट को तब तक नहीं छोड़ेंगे जब तक हम फ्रांस के लिए एक कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, एक संविधान, एक आईन ना बना ले. अब कैसा कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन? ऐसा कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन विच वुड लिमिट द पावर्स ऑफ द किंग. ये इन लोगों ने ओथ ले ली, एंड दिस इज नोन इन द फ्रेंच हिस्ट्री एज द टेनिस कोर्ट ओथ. दिस इज एन इंपॉर्टेंट एस्पेक्ट दैट कैन बी आस्क्ड फॉर 3 or 5 मार्क्स इन योर एग्जाम्स. सो अंडरस्टूड अबाउट द टेनिस कोर्ट ओथ, लेट्स मूव ऑन. Among this, there were some representatives of the second and third estates. See, maybe by now You might also be agreeing that the third state, representatives of the third states, were right in their demand. Of course they were right. So it happens that sometime good people are there in everywhere. So this is we're talking about Mirabeau. Of course third state had their own leaders, but some other leaders, this Mirabeau, he was a noble by birth. It means he was which state? Second state. And he wanted to destroy the feudal society. What is the feudal society? The society of France before the French Revolution was a feudal society. It means a king is the owner of the entire land in the country. The king would distribute this land to some people, and those people will be the owner of that land, and those people will force others to work on the land. So matlab ek jo gareeb kisan hai wo hamesha zameen pe ek naukar ki tarah hi kaam karega. Wo kabhi zameen ka malik nahi ho sakta. Wo bhi jayega to usko zyada adhikar nahi rahenge. That is feudal society. And this Mirabeau, though he was a noble by birth, he was against the system, and he published his own journal in support of third estate. Matlab wo ek writer bhi tha, aur usne he wrote many articles in support of the third estate and justifying the demands of the third estates. And during the indoor tennis court, he delivered a very powerful speech. Remember this, he delivered a very powerful speech during the indoor tennis court oath. And next is abbesses. He was a priest by birth. Matlab ye clergy tha, highest society, but he was also agreed with the views of Mirabeau and had sympathy for the third estate. And he also wrote a lot of articles, a lot of things in favor of third estate. His one article, that is what is the third estate, is very famous, which shows that he was sympathetic towards the third estate. Remember these two names, Mirabeau and abbesses. None of them, both of these were not from commoners. They were from one from nobility, another from clergy. Now new assembly, we have seen that the 600 representatives of the third estate had declared themselves the national assembly. Where? In the indoor tennis court. Why they went to the indoor tennis court? Because during the meeting of the estate general, they demanded there should be voting principle as one person one vote, which the king had rejected. So they went to the indoor tennis court and declared them national assembly. And when all these things were happening, it means Palace of Versailles, where all these things were going on. So it was a very heated situation in France, especially in Palace of Versailles. Yes, bahut bada political drama chal raha tha. Palace of Versailles matlab raja ke ghar mein, lekin sirf raja ke ghar mein drama nahi chal raha tha. All over France, the entire France was seethed with turmoil. Pura ka pura France mein uthal puthal machi hui thi. Pure France mein dange ho rahe the. Why all this thing happening? Because of the bad harvest. Number one, there was bad harvest. It means lack of food available to the people. Then price hike, demand of the food grain was high and the supply was less. So people fought against each other in search of food. There are some bad people who wanted to benefit from all the bad conditions. So some bakers means those people who sold these things, they took the advantage and they collected food grains with them so that we'll sell later, because as the time is passing by, prices will be going higher. So rather than selling the things today, we'll sell them tomorrow. The price will be high. People become angry because they didn't have anything to eat, so they attacked the shops. The riots everywhere, people were searching for the food and attacking the shops, and if they saw food grain in others' hand, they had a fight with them, snatched the food away, and there was all chaos and riots happening all over the country. That was happening exactly at the same time what was happening in the Palace of Versailles. That also we came to know. So to control all these things, king had called, see, we are going towards storming of Bastille. King called army in the city of Paris to control the situation, to control the riots. समझ में आ रहा है, राजा ने किस लिए आर्मी मंगाया? शहर में कम से कम दंगे तो रुक जाए भाई. लेकिन दंगे हो क्यों रहे थे? दंगे एक दूसरे के अगेंस्ट नहीं, दंगे तो खाने के लिए हो रहे थे, which is very justified demand. The king, rather than supplying the food to the people, he should make arrangement to that the people should get the food. He is calling army, asking the people to don't fight. Why wouldn't they fight? When king called army, people also got ready. We'll fight with the king now. We'll also attack. So that happened. Storming of Bastille, we have seen 14th of July 1789, where exactly we can say that the French Revolution conspicuously started, मतलब दिखने जैसी वहां से start हुई. Okay, what was happening in urban France that we have seen? Storming of Bastille ho gaya. What was happening in the rural areas now? Similar things happened in the rural areas. The riots were also happening in rural areas. Kuch afwaah phail gayi rural areas mein. Which rumors that some of people who were close to the king, they appointed some people and asked those gundas and brigands, say brigands means dakeet, daku. Some rich people attacked, hired some brigands, asked them to attack on the farms of the poor people and take away all the crop, standing crops of the people. ये अफवाह फैल गई कि राजा के कुछ supporters ने कुछ गुंडे hire किए हैं और उन्हें काम दिया है कि जनता के खेतों पे हमला करो, जो अनाज मिलता है वो सारा अनाज लूट के लेके आओ. लोग इतने नाराज हुए इससे कि खाने की पहले ही कमी थी और वो हमारे अफवाह, by the way it was a rumor, but लोगों ने भी फिर अपने जो हथियार उनके मिले, जो भी हथियार उनके थे, एग्रीकल्चर के टूल, वो लिए और ऐसे लोगों पे हमला कर दिया. और उन लोगों पे जहां राजा के जिन सपोर्टर्स पे हमला किया, उनके घर जला दिए, घर तोड़ दिए, उन लोगों की जान ले ली, उनके घर के अनाज लूट लिए, जो टैक्स के डॉक्यूमेंट्स थे वो डॉक्यूमेंट्स भी डिस्ट्रॉय कर दिए. और इतना बुरा हाल था कि जो नोबेल्स थे, जो राजा के सपोर्टर्स थे, उनका गांव छोड़ के भागना पड़ा अपनी जान बचाने के लिए, और कुछ लोग तो फ्रांस छोड़ के भी भाग गए. ये सिचुएशन थी जब पेरिस में कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन बन रही थी, जब नेशनल असेंबली ने अपने आप को, सॉरी द थर्ड स्टेट ने जब अपने आप को नेशनल असेंबली डिक्लेयर किया. ऑल दिस थिंग्स वर हैपनिंग. नाउ यू कैन अंडरस्टैंड व्हेन ऑल दिस थिंग्स वर हैपनिंग आउट ऑफ फ्रांस, आउट ऑफ पेरिस, थ्रू आउट द फ्रांस, एवर इन द पेरिस देयर वाज स्टॉर्मिंग ऑफ बस्टाइल. एंड हु वर डूइंग दैट? ऑल दोस पीपल वेर द सपोर्टर्स ऑफ द थर्ड स्टेट, एंड दैट थर्ड स्टेट व्हिच हैड डिक्लेयर्ड देमसेल्व्स एज अ नेशनल असेंबली. नाउ डू यू थिंक किंग हैज अ डेयरिंग इनफ to reject the National Assembly now? No. King will have to accept, because representatives with third estate, those 600 people could only control the population outside, and King had to accept them. Let's see what happened. Finally, pressurized by the urban and the rural situation, Louis XVI, what did he do? We saw what was happening outside. King saw there was storming of Bastille occurred. What was happening in rural areas also we have seen. King's supporters, maybe some of them, maybe king's relatives were killed. The king accepted, recognized the National Assembly. Raja ne National Assembly ko manyata di. Yes, you third estate people, 600 representatives, you are the National Assembly. I agree. National Assembly means you are the people who will officially make laws for France. I agree that you are a National Assembly. And he said that, okay, whatever constitution you people have drafted, I'll accept that constitution. And according to your constitution, if you don't allow me to take some decisions, I agree. Whatever you have written in the constitution, I accept. And I'm ready to be a constitutional monarch. Till now, what the king was? He was absolute monarch. Ab tak wo nirankush raja tha. Ab wo nirankush nahi. Ab wo controlled monarch ho gaya. Ab wo constitutional monarch ho gaya. Pehle kya tha wo? Absolute monarch. अब हो गया वो constitutional monarch. Now the king had accepted the National Assembly and accepted the draft of the constitution also, and he agreed that his powers would be limited. Then National Assembly came on the form now, started taking decision. So the 4th of August 1789, the National Assembly had taken some very important decisions. And what decisions were there? Feudal system of obligation and taxes were removed. Feudal system of obligation and taxes were abolished. इसका मतलब अब कोई पहले जो third estate को मजबूर किया जाता था कि tax दो किनको? Clergy को tax दो या फिर nobility को tax दो, ऐसा ऐसा कोई tax अब नहीं चलेगा. Even the clergy had to give up their privileges. Clergy को जो अधिकार थे, कोई अधिकार नहीं रहेगा, बस church में रहो, तुमको पैसा मिलेगा, खाना खाओ, पूजा पाठ करो, बस यही काम करो, पैसा प्रॉपर्टी के पीछे मत दौड़ो. इवन 33 टैक्स वाज अबॉलिश्ड, कोई टैक्स नहीं दिया जाएगा चर्च को. एंड द लैंड ऑफ द ऑक्युपाइड बाय चर्च वेयर कॉन्फिस्केटेड, चर्च की जमीनों को जब्त कर लिया गया. और टोटल कितने वैल्यू की प्रॉपर्टी आई? 2 बिलियन लीवर. इतनी प्रॉपर्टी नेशनल असेंबली ने एक लॉ पास करके हासिल कर ली. दीज वर द अर्ली डिसीजंस ऑफ द नेशनल असेंबली. Now here we come to an end of this video. So what have we studied here so far? Here, thing called the meeting of a state general to impose or levy a new tax. And what principle he wanted to follow? He wanted to follow one state, one vote. But the third state were demanded one person, one vote. King rejected and all these people walked out of the meeting of a state general and went to the indoor tennis court where they declared themselves as the National Assembly. When all these things were happening inside the Palace of Versailles, the France war was seething with turmoil. France. Dange chal rahe the pure France mein. And finally, considering all the situation, the king accepted the National Assembly, and the National Assembly made some laws, confiscated the property of church, abolished the old feudal system. And here we come to an end. Finally, we'll see which kind of constitution the National Assembly had drafted. About this constitution, we will be studying in the next video. I hope you have understood. If you have not understood anything, comment here. I'll assure you, I'll answer every question that you put in the comment. Soon, see you in the next video, or possibly the fourth video is also available. Click on the I button, you'll see second and the fourth video both. Thank you so much. Goodbye. Keep learning.